Welcome to the award-winning Champions Mojo, hosted by two world record-holding athletes and health, life, and leadership coaches. And now, just the takeaways from your hosts, Kelly Pallas and Maria Parker.
Well, Maria, that was just so, I felt like she was so authentic and really did an amazing job, you know, and it was 10 o'clock there and, you know,
PM,
8 o'clock,
right,
PM,
right.
PM. So she was really, really energetic and very focused. So I think that's something we're going to talk about. So,
right.
It was awesome.
Yeah.
What was your first takeaway?
She impressed me because clearly she, well, I said the overarching theme was focus and discipline. I mean, she has focused and planned and put discipline, you know, and discipline herself to the point really where she wasn't even listening to, you know, as an athlete, you have to tell your body to stop yelling because it hurts. But she, you know, she is able to do that to an extreme. And I think that's why she's been successful. She knows what she wants. She does what she's supposed to do even more. And she's incredibly disciplined to be able to switch training venues all the time and still be successful in training partners and coaches. And I thought she was really amazing. I aspire to be that disciplined.
Yes. And discipline is something that a lot of athletes have, but not maybe to the extreme that she has. And discipline is, it's so important. We did a whole show on it. I think it's like the key to success.
Yeah.
So, I think that's one of
her
superpowers.
You grow it, and she has grown it. It's a tree in her life.
Yeah. Her superpower.
Yeah.
My first takeaway that I think would be another kind of overarching theme of Siobhan is that she's a super positive person.
Yeah.
You know, she puts a great spin on anything, even with her foot, she's just plowing through. She's looking at it in the best possible light that she can. But she said, you know, that she thinks that's a trait of champions and one which she certainly demonstrates. But yeah, she could be so negative on, just like you said, on having to travel a lot and having to be in, you know, not with her ideal coach, the coach that's sending her workouts, but she's just really positive about everything. And I think that just buoys her up and makes her better. So
yeah,
I completely agree.
I love that aspect of her personality. Yeah, because as the interview went on, we heard about her obstacles were like,
right. How has she been doing this?
I mean, I never even read that anywhere. So, I mean, you know, it's not out there. She's not complaining. So that's probably, so my second takeaway would be that she is an incredible planner, but also has learned to be flexible. So, I mean, those two cannot go hand in hand sometimes. Like I like to plan things and I don't like it when things don't go the way I plan them. But being a planner is great. I mean, she knows what she wants to do after her swimming career, and she's, you know, she thinks through things, and, you know, planning can be hard, but if you plan, you know, you have a sense of boundaries and you know where you're going. So she was a great planner, but also she was able to flex with her plans and change them. And she said the ISL experience has made her rethink, you know, going right to grad school after the Olympics and trying to, you know, enjoy being a professional swimmer. So I love that about her, that she could say, I had this plan, but you know what? I'm going to change it.
Yes. Yeah. That was an excellent, excellent one. My final takeaway is one that I think is just, it's so applicable to all of us with anything that we're really grinding against. So something chronic, and it doesn't have to be a chronic illness. If it doesn't have to be migraines or, you know, chronic back pain or, you know, but her foot pain is chronic, that kind of, what is the prayer? Grant me the wisdom to accept the things I cannot change and the serenity to change the things I can, accept the things
courage
I cannot
to change.
Change
the thing I can.
Yeah.
The courage to change. We're really screwing this.
It's early in the morning for us. We usually don't get this early. I've not had my coffee.
The last one is the wisdom to know the difference.
The wisdom to know the difference. So I think anything that we're grinding against, instead of saying, you know, maybe it's never going to change. So just kind of
Serenity to accept.
Serenity, like accepting, you know, maybe this is just the way her foot's always going to be. Maybe this is the way my back is always going to be. How can I live the best life that I can live with this condition, whatever that is? You know,
maybe it could be a difficult relationship. It could be a situation in your job.
Yeah.
You know, knowing, you know, when you try to change things and get better and things don't, and just knowing, okay, I'm going to live with this for a while and be serene about it.
Yeah. Yeah. So I loved that one. I related to that one. A great takeaway for me. And just there were a lot more, but hopefully you'll listen to the whole interview. Yeah. And Maria, thank you so much. And this was a little different for us being up early in the morning to do this.
But. You can probably tell by my hair, but all right, Kelly, love you.
I love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
You've been listening to the Champions Mojo podcast with host Kelly Pallas and Maria Parker. Champions Mojo is produced by Cabra Media, and a new episode debuts every Tuesday. Subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts and leave us a 5-star review. Follow Champions Mojo on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook @ Champions Mojo.